morning, guys, and welcome back. Well, my dog Hannah got here after midnight, so was no wait for him. I went to bed. Now I've located the trailer. It's not in the best spot, but that's all right. I was hoping that he left it in a spot so I can reverse the double into it, but nah, I'll have to go and take it from there and bring it behind the double. Okay, I'm not in the best place for this sort of maneuver, but try my best. So these guys parked too much in. And that doesn't give me enough room to put the trailer straight behind. So I have to do a bit of back and forth maneuvers. Getting there. Okay. Push the two trailers into the last one. quickly park here for a few minutes so I can go and wash my hands and then have a quick breakfast and hit the road. Alright, so let's go.
Thank you very much, guys.
Have a good one.
You too. like having a bit of storm over there. I mean, I was told last night that that's the case. Well, I should be in Newman by 7 o'clock tonight. About 930 kilometers to go. 8:30 in the morning. So yeah, 7 o'clock, or 10.5 hours. An hour from when I wake up until I left Uban. Check the truck, hook up the trailers, made a quick breakfast and coffee, and now, yeah, on the way. This trip, I got the two reefers at the front and the dry pen at the back. Now the reefers are quite heavy. When I left depot and I went on a Y bridge, the front one was close to capacity. I had 16.3 ton on a drive axle, 200 kilo under, and 18 ton on a dry, so 2.2 ton under the full capacity on the first one, and I was about 3.5 under full capacity on the second one. So yeah, a heavy load. The dry pen is not that heavy. It is heavy, but not that much. I mean, it's got quite a bit of linen in it. So, I'll say it's three quarters of the capacity. A guy behind me trying to overtake, but unfortunately I can't help him because I can't see what's happening ahead. going on behind the crest. If I can't really see clearly what's happening, I'm not signaling anyone to overtake. If they wanna do on their own risk, it's their problem. Different story. I can see almost 2 kilometers ahead. Well, what happened here? Do the oversizes again. Something like this on the coast. Before I left, I was quickly reading through some of the comments on the last episode. Especially the small operators which are not which cannot afford to pay that well, they take on board anyone who can drive a truck. It's not the right way, but this is the reality in these days. Slowly, slowly we become a high commodity. Young people don't even want to look at the trucks anymore. They won't, they don't want to put the effort in anymore. Whatever is more than 8 hours a day, it's way too hard for them. Plus, especially on a line haul, them to work 17 hours and then go to bed for 7 and go again for 17, and that, no way in the world. It's basically impossible for them to do that. If they are forced to do that, they'll commit suicide. Imagine working 17 hours, hang on, they missing so many hours from away from the video games and from social media and from all this. What are you talking about, working 17 hours? Not even 10. As soon as the 8 hours are done, out of the door. As soon as they're accumulating one sickie, Jesus, they have to take a straight away, not let accumulate two. No. One have to be taken. When I left the other branch, the other division of toll, intermodal, I left behind around 300 hours of sickies. Enormous amount. Well, everyone was asking, oh, why you didn't take them? Why you didn't take them? Why? How can I take them if I don't get sick? Just pretend to be sick and take them? Sorry, that's not me. If I'm sick, I'm sick. I take them. If I'm not, nah. Instead of pretending that I'm sick, I'll rather say, hey guys, I need a day off. How much annual leave I got? Oh, you got none. Okay, give me a day without pay. This is how I work. And yeah, I don't just pretend that I'm sick to take a day off. I can't do that. Even my family was saying, oh, you are crazy for doing that. Well, yeah, but this is how I work, this is how I've been all the time, honest all the way, and this is how I build up my reputation. Driver, okay, he got stood down from a CTI, but I'm sure that he's already driving for someone else. which is fair enough. I mean, I didn't want him to lose his job. I just wanted him to realize that what he done is not acceptable. And he shouldn't do things like that. So I just wanted someone to have a good talk with him. But CTI decided to shoot him down. Yeah, well, not much I can do, it's out of my hands. But I'm sure that he's already driving somewhere else. Funny, a few months ago I received a phone call all of a sudden, looked at the number, didn't recognize the number, but because it was a number, was not ID or anything like that, no caller ID. So yeah, so number, okay, I answer. And was an ex-recruiter from Tall People. I used to work with her when I was in management, calling her every day for the casual labor that I needed. He moved as a in a HR position to K-Trans. And she saw my profile on a SIG, and she saw that I'm back driving. She called me to see if I'm interested to jump the fence. So this is showing how desperate people are for drivers. Everywhere. Everyone is advertising. Because the younger generation just doesn't want to do it anymore. Plus, well, here in WA, we are lucky. We don't have to put up with all that bullshit like in Eastern States. Logbook and all that. Yeah, we have the fatigue book, which is different. But in the logbook, you have to write your odometer number, where you stop, location, and the exact time, and all that. Nah, not us. Yeah, I write my odometer number when I leave the depot. I write it again where I finish for the day. I write it next day when I start. It's just the start and the end of the day. You don't write kilometers where you stop and all that and that and yeah, no. So we don't have that that sort of stuff. And soon, well, not yet, but if I'll, if they'll keep pushing and I'll sign to become a permanent, so far they didn't manage to set up my runs as we agree for the kilometers, so I'm still casual. And against, but once they will manage to sort out my runs to my expectation, and I'll sign up as a permanent, then I won't be doing the manual fatigue books and all that. Will be done on the computer, on the little palm device that we got, the mobile data terminal on the MDT. We have the facility to do the daily run sheet on it. But till then, keep doing on paper. Sorry guys, I got a couple of LVs behind me, and it's a bit hilly here, losing speed. Not much I can do, guys. And what you're doing, mate, it's a bit stupid. If something was coming, very impatient, some of the guys. Don't be a hero. What the hell you doing, mate? It's a truck coming, and is nothing behind the truck for 3 kilometers. But nah, he had to do it before the truck was passing. Overtaking, it's a very, very risky maneuver. It doesn't matter if you see that you have a free line for a kilometer. If something is coming on a high speed from opposite direction, you start overtaking one of these 50 meter long vehicle. Halfway through, something happened with your car, with the fuel or something, and you can't make the speed, and you start slowing down. You have two choices: brake hard and get back, or go bush, because otherwise you'll go head on. Especially when you see that something is only 300-400 meters away, you don't overtake. Doesn't matter how powerful is your four-wheel drive. You don't know what sort of fuel did you got from the last service station, how good it is. Well, usually, most of the time, I can make it from Perth to Capricornia with one.
Oh my God, the century, I'm going through that.
With one full, no problem. But when it's heavy load like now, it's a bit touch and go, a bit risky. I'm just about to get to Pine Pines. So I'm not even halfway through, and I already used one third of the fuel. It's a bit too close for comfort to try to get with one fuel to Capi. So what I might do is don't know the condition, what's happening in what's happening in Mecca, because it was raining last night, it was a storm, so I'm going to stop in a queue and fill up in there. I don't want to be catched, and not to be able to fill up in Mecca, and then my only hope left will be wait. Okay, she managed. My only hope left will be Kew Marina. Not to put myself in that position, I'll get some fuel in the queue. If that doesn't work, then I got Mecca and Kew Marina left. So I'm not, I don't rely on just one service station. And that's why it's good when you have three different fuel cards. BP, Shell and Ample. Also, Shell card will work at Liberty service stations as well, so basically I have four options. saw some piles of gravel being dumped in there. So it looks like they're starting. Oh, someone had a surprise. Blow up tire.
Guys have called the roadkill before. Are you still on channel?
Yeah, so I'll start saying looks like they start fixing up the parking base in Pine Pines. So a couple of big piles of gravel dipped there. So finally they're doing something about that parking base. When it's raining, it's just a big patch of mud. Well, there's the Gerald on Terno, turning left here. We'll cut across, try to Geraldton. This is the Geraldton Mount Magnet Road. Anyway, we're just about to get through Mount Magnet. As we speak, I'm sitting on a half of the fuel tanks. So too close for comfort, not to top her up before getting to Newman. So I'll do it in queue. Side of the road and on the road. Not sure if it's from sprinklers or it's from the rain last night. But looks more like it's from the rain, yeah. Because it's not just on the main street, it's also on the side. But everything else, it's empty rivers. stage. Don't know what's happening on the other side of Kew and between Katara and Kew Marina. Usually there's a place where always is trouble. Everything looking. This one is a bit soft. Okay, it's not flat. The inside one is okay. These two are okay. It's just a bit soft, that one, but yeah, this two looks okay. Yeah, looking okay. Yep, all good. And this one, yeah. Thank you. a bit of drama, but let's hope it's gonna hold. Everything else looks good. Beautiful. Okay, so I got about 600 liters of fuel, which almost filled up. That will do nicely. So now I don't have to worry until tomorrow after finishing unloading. As usual, very quiet through the town. A lot of emergency service people in the caravan park. They were prepared for any eventual problems with the cyclone. A lot of them were traveling yesterday towards Carnarvon. There are more, from what I understood. I spoke with a couple of them in a service station. There are more of them in Mika on a standby. Oh yeah. Excuse me. Yeah, apparently was a bit of storm last night, which it's gone towards the east now, but They are expecting another one tonight, which is what's left of the cyclone. Don't know if it's gonna bring any much rain around here. Will be more like a wind, more wind than anything else. But anyway, next stop will be Camarina. So if you Marina have a something to eat, and then all the way to Warawando and set up everything for tomorrow. Well, we got a loaded quad. Got some sort of rocks, don't know what is. But I have an opportunity. I need to go around because it's sitting on 67, which is not ideal for me. Looks like they escaped from the station because they got the tags in their ears, so they are not a strikeout. See what happened after this crest. Yeah, after this it's another one and so on. The best place to overtake, especially since my speed dropped at 55. Okay, we're catching a bit of speed, so that will be easier to overtake. Are we looking in MLG? Okay, on my way, thank you. bye-bye. No matter what we do, we can't lose the accent. Countries. Well, looks like wasn't much of a rain, was more wind last night and the lightning around here. We'll see how it's on the other side of Mika. By now, you can see a clear sky, so even if it was a bit of flooding, it should be gone by now. We'll see.
Two and seven and a half, thanks,
Offer. Yeah, no, thank you. activity around here. And it's not to say that it's one of that hot days that everyone is hiding. It's only 37, nice and actually nice and mild for Mikatara. Few people at the swimming pool. Of the storm, a few puddles of water here, there, but nothing serious. So now, because I stopped in queue, don't have to stop here. Can go all the way to Q Marina. I'll stop there in my favorite spot, on top of the hill. I'm talking about the inland. We are all helping each other, not like coastal where no one talks with you. It's only a handful.
Yeah, mate. Check it, mate.
Thank you very much, mate.
No worries.
You know, the only ones that help you and talk with you on a coastal drive is the ones which are also driving here. A part of that, forget about. I don't know why, but yeah. Bit of water here, there. So this is where all the problems were last night. Dry up very quick. Well, it's still soft on the edge, so I won't be going out from the bitumen. I'll stay on the bitumen. But yes, I am very well. this is where the water was actually covering the road. So it's only a big puddle left. Apparently last night was about 5 inches of water over the road around here. Between Nicotera and Kumarina.
I'll have my ticket out there, I'll get you in. Yeah, your platform's back here, thanks, Doctor.
At Kew Marina, about 25-30 kilometers, and I should be there. Another 150 kilometers from Kew Marina to Capricornia. Unfortunately, that's the worst part of the trip, if something happened, when you break down, because there's no phone coverage, you only have about 20 kilometers plus to Marina, not even that, and then nothing until you are about 30 kilometers from Capricornia. Even that, it's a bit patchy. It's not a good coverage. Not worth it to spend the money to take them back and fix, so they just leave them on the side of the road. Just abandon them and see you later. They take all the number plates, hand them back to Department of Transport, and yep. You can see the top of the hill. So there for 20 minutes and have something to eat and then keep going. Time to eat. Just bumped in one of our sabi. It's having a bit of a drama with his reaper. He's not holding the temperature. He'll be alright soon. Soon will cool down, so then I'll be alright. Okay, time to have something to eat. For this stage, we're looking at 7 p.m. Arrival at Warawando. I will see when I get there. if I'm in a mood to do anything, to go in for dinner or not. I just had something to eat before, so I don't think I will go. Just get the trailers ready and have some sleep. Get plenty rest for tomorrow morning. Okay. Passing Cappy. So straight to Warawando. going to the gate. I need to get my access card from the back. Point arriving at the gate without access card. This Muppet always had to park in the middle. Can he park on the side? Alright, so there we are, Warrawandoo. Well, I will quickly go in to grab a coffee and a cold drink and I'll be back. Well guys, all set up, all ready. Unhooked the last trailer. Went in, brought myself a coffee, a bottle of mineral water, and I'm ready to go to bed till tomorrow morning. You have a good night and see you then.